You're about to learn how to install and run Linux on your jailbroken PS4 by watching this video tutorial. Stay tuned. Sup folks, DexTechPro with a new one. In this demonstration, I'm going to be teaching you how to install one of a powerful Linux distro called Gentoo on your jailbroken PS4 in order to transfer your console into a personal computer. The question is this, why would I install Linux on my PS4? And the answer is, you can turn it into an awesome PC gaming to experience PC games, a tremendous game emulator to play different consoles games, and a virtual machine in order to run a huge number of software categories such as Microsoft Office, video and audio editors, tools and utilities, and a lot more, guys. I mean, this is Linux, and you should already know that Linux has a lot of distros, and this Gentoo that I'm gonna install is stable and capable with beautiful graphical user interface. Alright, I'm gonna name requirements before I go for it. To get started, we need to prep a computer USB keyboard and mouse, a dedicated 12GB and more USB stick or hard disk drive, Gentoo Linux, which I put the download link in description, Rufus for Windows, link is in description as well, PS4 Gentoo Linux exploit host, designed by Leafl developer, and that's all we need. Alrighty, time to get the show on. First off, download Rufus and Gentoo Linux from the link in description. We need to mount the Gentoo Linux on USB stick in order to boot it up on PlayStation 4. So, connect USB stick to computer. The one that I'm using is with 32GB of capacity. Okay, open up Rufus. Click on Select and open Gentoo Linux image file. Click on Start. It warns you that you're gonna lose all data on USB stick, which is not a big deal to me. So I click on OK. Wait till it's all copied and mounted on the USB stick. It's gonna make two partitions on USB stick. The first one with 200MB FAT32, which will contain Linux bootloader that boots up PlayStation 4 into loading. And the second partition is gonna be 10GB with ext4 file system, which hosts mounted image of Gentoo Linux on it. So the rest of my USB stick's capacity will be unallocated and useless, but I'll use it by allocating it back and adding it up to that 10GB partition when the PS4 is booted up with Linux later on this video tutorial. Okay, the USB stick is ready. Click on Close. Unplug and plug it back to PC again, making sure the partitions are created. Right-click on Computer. Manage. Disk Management. Here is my USB with 210GB of partitions, and I got 18GB of unallocated size, which I will fix it inside Gentoo Linux as I mentioned before. Alright, close them all. I'm done with the USB stick. You can unplug and plug it back to PS4. Great, get back to PS4. There are a couple of things that you need to get done in settings before we go for booting stage. First off, we need to fix the output resolution to 1080p, avoiding any possible black screen issue when Gentoo Linux is loading up. So go to Settings, Sound and Screen, Video Output Settings, Resolution, set it to 1080p. Turn off HDR if it's on. Cool. Get back to dashboard. Connect PS4 to the internet and open up the web browser. There mustn't be any other pre-cached pages in a web browser, otherwise you'll be facing error messages and troubles. So you gotta delete everything and flush the cache of the browser to run Gentoo Linux payload nice and easy. Press Option button on the controller. Delete everything in browsing history. And inside Settings, delete cookies plus website data. Guess I'm all set. Close and open it up back again. Time to get it done by going to https://ps4gentoo.github.io. Once you browse it, it starts to cache all the payloads on the PS4 hard disk drive. That's why we deleted all pre-installed data and cache in order to avoid any conflicts. Alrighty, caching is done, all set for the next step. Time to load up the Linux loader. As you can see, we got three different Linux loaders with different versions. Since there is no description on this, I tried them all, but only the second one worked with this distro of Gentoo on my PS4 Pro. It may vary from console to console or Gentoo Linux versions. For you, if the second one ain't work, you gotta go for the first or third one. So I go for Linux 4.1998. Alright, plug Gentoo Linux USB stick, keyboard and mouse to your PS4. I'm using this USB hub in order to expand USB ports on my PS4 Pro. Then I inject this Linux loader from here. Alright, PS4 restarts and boots up from USB stick. It takes few seconds till the signal's back. Here we go, signal's back. Now it's booting up. And here we are, successfully booted into Gentoo Linux. Congratulations, that was fast though. For your information, running Gentoo Linux doesn't change your PS4 internal hard drive because we are booting it up from USB stick. So every changes you make won't affect PS4 internal HDD or hard drive. That being said, all of your data and games will be totally intact. You can get back to your PS4 dashboard and games from Linux by restarting the Gentoo very easily. Alrighty guys, first off, let's change the panel and move it down the screen, making it more accessible. Right click on panel, edit panel, then click on remove panel. Right click on desktop, hover your mouse cursor on add panel, then click on default panel. Right click on it, click on edit panel, click on the screen edge, drag and move it down the screen, then close it. That's what I want. Great. Okay, as you can see, the fonts and icons here are super small. So the next step is scaling the display up to have a good vision on it. Click on menu lower left corner of the screen. Click on system settings. Scroll down to reach hardware and click on display and monitor. In display configuration, I change the global scale to 1.8. Then I apply it. It needs a restart to apply the change. So click on menu again, go to leave, hit on restart and restart again. It restarts into PS4 system software, not the Linux. So we need to inject the Gentoo loader and boot it up again. So I do it again. Okay, here we are and it looks way better. If you're already a Windows user, which I believe you are, then you won't be having trouble operating this Gentoo Linux. Just go to see its features and options yourself and try to get familiar more with them. Because the more you use, the better you understand. Right, guys? Okay, that's great. Developers already put the PS4 hardware drivers inside this distro and you can even use Bluetooth and Wi-Fi as well. You can also plug the gamepad to play by clicking on this little gamepad icon lower right corner of the screen and opening up Anti-Micro X app to recognize and map the gamepad into Gentoo Linux. Let's extend and allocate the unallocated capacity of my 32GB USB stick by going to menu and opening up Gparted, the partition editor. The username and password are PS4, all lowercase, and for the root access, which is the same as administrator, the username is root, the password is PS4. Right click on partition. Click on resize move. Drag and drop this slider all to the right in order to resize and use the whole capacity of the USB stick. Then click on resize. Here we go. As you can see, the change is applied and now you can use the whole capacity of the USB stick to install games and software later on. Okay, close it. Back in the menu, we got Dolphin File Manager to browse and share USB stick contents from or to other external or network storages. We got game emulators that helps you to play games of other consoles on Gentoo Linux as well. Go back to menu again, applications and games. As you can see, we got pre-installed gaming emulators to play PlayStation 1 and 2 games, Wii, Sega Saturn, and so many more in here. You can even install and run Windows apps inside Gentoo Linux by going back to menu, application, wine, and experience Windows environment inside the Linux. I'll be covering Gentoo operating system more and teach you how to run games from different consoles or platforms on it in the future. Hope you enjoyed watching, and that's the end of this video tutorial. Have a good one, guys.